आज आपका नाम लिखा गया, मेरा नहीं है।
Good afternoon, sir.
Very good afternoon, Akriti ji.
Good afternoon, sir.
Very good afternoon, Professor Monica.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon. Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Runna ji.
आईपैड से चला रहा क्या लाइव है प्रोग्राम
Good afternoon, everyone. So, Prashant sir, our chief guest, Shri Prashant Kumar Singh is here with us. So, with your due permission, sir, can we start with the program? Sir, you have to unmute yourself.
Yes, you may pursue now.
Thank you, sir. VC sir, should we start with the program now?
Yes, Akriti ji.
Thank you, sir. So we'll start with the program. A very good afternoon to one and all present here today. On behalf of ICPA University Jharkhand, I, Akriti Gupta, along with Monica Verma ma'am, Faculty of Law, would like to welcome everyone present here for the Constitution Day celebration. I would like to extend my warm welcome to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor ORS Rao sir, our respected Registrar of IUJ, Professor Arvind Kumar sir, our Assistant Dean, IUJ Dr. Bhagwat Barik sir, all the respected HODs, faculties and students present here, with special mention to our chief guest, Shri Prashant Kumar Singh, who is a member of BCI Jharkhand. So we'll begin the Constitution Day celebration with auspicious virtual lighting of the lamp, and I would request the tech team to please play the lighting of the lamp.
अस्तु मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा ममृतं गमय लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु ॐ शान्तिः 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 ॐ
सो आई वुड लाइक टू बिगिन दिस प्रोग्राम विद मोनिका मैम. Starting with her speech, she would like to enlighten us and tell us a few words about Constitution Day. Over to you, ma'am.
Good afternoon to one and all present here. Today it's an auspicious day for all of us as we are celebrating Constitution Day, also known as Samvidhan Divas. The historical significance lies in the fact that on 26 November 1949, the Constitution of India was legally adopted by the Constituent Assembly of India, and which later came into effect on 26 January 1950 and become one of the longest written constitution of the world. The Ministry of Social Justice and Employment on 19th November 2015 decided to commemorate this day as Constitution Day. This day is also celebrated to pay tribute to our Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, who was the chairman of the drafting committee and also the first law minister of India. It is a day to express gratitude to the makers of the Constitution and to reiterate our commitment to building the India of their dreams. Let us keep the spirit of our Constitution alive. With these words, I now welcome our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Sir Professor ORS Rao, sir, to please share his insight and also address the gathering. Sir, please.
Thank you very much, Professor Akriti Gupta and Professor Monica Verma. Shri Prashant Kumar Singh Ji, Member Bar Council of India. Shri Pradeep Bhattacharya Ji, Senior Advocate and Member Dhanbad Bar Council. Professor Arvind Kumar Registrar, Dr. Barik Assistant Dean. Professor Alok Kumar, the head of the department for the law department, all my dear senior and other faculty members, and all the students, a very good afternoon and my hearty welcome to all of you to today's Constitution Day, Samvidhan Divas, that is organized by our university in association with the District Legal Services Authority, Ranchi. Professor Monica Verma has briefly mentioned to you about the significance of the Constitution Day. As we celebrate the 75 years of independence, Ajadika Amrit Mahotsav, Ajadika Amrit Mahotsav, as we celebrate, this year's celebration of the Constitution Day assumes more significance. Because as a democracy, we have, you know, sort of remained stable and stronger, you know, over the last 75 years. So that is a tribute to the entire country. On this occasion, I wish all of you a very happy Constitution Day. The architects of our Constitution, led by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, drafted our Constitution, putting in a lot of efforts and spent maybe he and his team, they worked, you know, for about 2 years, taking the best from the constitutions from a number of countries in the world, like UK, Australia, Canada, South Africa. Of course, between them and us, the common thing is we are all part of the Commonwealth countries, and we had, you know, sort of similar rules and regulations that were followed by the British. Not only them, but also from the various developed countries like the United States, Germany, and Japan. And as Madam has mentioned, it's a handwritten document considered to be not only the largest kind of a constitution, but also one of the sort of a longest handwritten kind of a documents in the entire world. It's something like, you know, more than 1.17 lakh words, you know. It's not an easy thing, both in English and Hindi, they have to think separately. On November 26th, 1949, when the Constituent Assembly met, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the president of the Constituent Assembly, in his speech, what he said is something very, very insightful. And this is what was quoted by our Honorable Prime Minister also in today morning's function. So for the benefit of all of you, I wanted to repeat that. What he said is, no matter how beautiful and well-organized and strong any constitution that is made, if it is not run by the true fearless and selfless servants of the country, then the Constitution cannot do anything. Of course, maybe I think, you know, maybe in a positive sense, you know, when he meant was, like when he says that, you know, maybe he's referring to, you know, all the people of the country, not be separating to Krishna. So all of us are aware that, you know, the fruits of freedom are to reach all the citizens of the country. It's important that all the three organs of the democracy, that is the legislature, executive, and the judiciary, they have to work in unison. Perhaps I think that's what Dr. Rajendra Prasad has mentioned. So he mentioned to all the people when he said all the servants later that. So while the legislature lays down the policies, the executive, that is bureaucracy, implements them, the principal role of the judiciary is to protect the rule of law and ensure supremacy of law. Considering that today, like this function is being organized by our law department, so it is a matter of pride for all of us that despite the COVID-19 pandemic, the entire judiciary in the country, starting with the highest court, Supreme Court, up to the lowest level courts, they have been playing their role very admirably. It's not an easy thing at all, you know, sort of, you know, through technology or otherwise, all important issues that are relevant for the citizens, whatever issues that are faced by the citizens during this, you know, pandemic, they were all addressed very, very effectively. Possibly in the last sort of few years, you know, we have been seeing, you know, very, very active role of the judiciary, and they are playing the role to uphold the values into that, to see that, you know, not only the other two organs also, sort of, they play the role very well. Apart from that, it's equally important to build awareness among the people in order to see that the fruits reach the people. You know, yes, it's important to build awareness among the people, particularly the uneducated people, with regard to their fundamental rights and duties as enshrined in the Constitution. In this context, our university has been doing, you know, a good job, doing its best to take up this task. Besides providing a range of legal services to the poor people, our university's the Legal Services Clinic has been conducting a number of awareness campaigns on the rights and duties of the people, particularly in the neighboring villages, by way of posters, nukkad, you know, videos, and, you know, shows, various types of things. As a matter of fact, the whole of the today morning, all of our students, guided by our faculty members, they visited the villages and covered a number of such items, you know, today morning. I would like to appreciate, you know, the efforts of our, all of our law faculty members and students in this regard. That is something very, very important to what we are doing. In fact, as a matter of fact, today's afternoon's function also, you will see a lot of them that have been covered. A lot of awareness kind of a programs among the students and otherwise into that. Once again, I wish all of you a very happy Constitution Day. And I also wish all of you an educative and enjoyable function for today. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for enlightening us. I would now like to invite Professor ORS Rao, sir, Vice Chancellor IUJ, for the oath ceremony. I would also like to request everyone to please mute yourself and repeat after, sir.
Yeah, the preamble for the Constitution, that is what, you know, I would read. It's in English, what was sent to me. We,
the people of India,
having solemnly resolved to constitute India.
Into a sovereign
socialist, secular, democratic republic. And to secure to all its citizens. justice, that is social, economic, and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity.
Of status and of opportunity.
And to provide among them all.
And to provide among them all.
Fraternity.
Fraternity.
Assuring. Dignity of the individual.
The dignity of the individual.
And the unity.
And unity.
Integrity of the nation.
And integrity of the nation.
So this is sort of what was adopted in the Constituent Assembly. In our Constituent Assembly is 26th of November 1949 to hereby adopt that and give to ourselves this Constitution.
This 26th of November 1949 to hereby adopt it and give to ourselves this Constitution.
आलोक जी आपका हिंदी वर्षन चाहे तो आप पढ़ लीजिए.
आलोक सर बिफोर यू स्टार्ट कैन आई जस्ट इंटरप्ट. आई वुड प्लीज लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू म्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड देन सो दैट इट इज नॉट अ कियोस.
हम भारत के लोग
भारत को
संपूर्ण
प्रभुत्व संपन्न
समाजवादी पंथ निरपेक्ष लोकतंत्रात्मक गणराज्य बनाने के लिए तथा उसके समस्त नागरिकों को सामाजिक आर्थिक
और राजनीतिक
न्याय
विचार
अभिव्यक्ति
विश्वास
धर्म
और उपासना की स्वतंत्रता
प्रतिष्ठा और अवसर की समता
प्राप्त करने के लिए
तथा उन सबों में व्यक्ति की गरिमा और राष्ट्र की एकता और अखंडता सुनिश्चित करने वाली बंधुता पढ़ाने के लिए दृढ़ संकल्प होकर आज इस संविधान सभा में 26 नवंबर 1949 ईस्वी को एतत द्वारा इस संविधान को अंगीकृत और आत्मसमर्पित करते हैं.
धन्यवाद.
Thank you everyone for cooperating and thank you, sir. Taking the program forward, I would request our Chief Justice, Shri Prashant Kumar Singh, member of Bar Council of India, Jharkhand, to address the gathering and share a few words on this auspicious occasion. Sir.
Thank you. Honorable Vice Chancellor, ICFA University, dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen, and organizer. And my dear lawyers and students of other faculties, I am very pleased with this opportunity to attend this Constitutional Day program organized to commemorate the adoption of the Constitution of our country on 26th November 8 of November 1949. An opportunity to express my views. First of all, I like to congratulate the Kufai University for organizing this program, which remind us about the need and importance of the constitution of our country. And provide us an opportunity to discuss matter related to its implementation, and most important of all, inspire us to think as to how we individual as well as collective could contribute to promote constitutional value and to achieve the constitutional objects. It is for these reasons that the central government took a decision and issued a notification in the year 2015 to celebrate the day each year. As our Vice Chancellor sir has already mentioned about certain aspect of the matter, of our beauty of our constitution, that how it has been adopted from different part of the country and the best we have taken, and now we are implementing also. This is the beauty of our constitution, that we can adopt in this way also. Friends, as we know, the constitution is regarded as the fundamental law of the country, a touchstone which is used to adjust the validity of any law passed by any government or other institution, and a guide for the government at the center and state and local bodies levels. It is the document which protect democracy through encouragement to a constitutional values and through a system of separation of power, check and balance among the institution which derives from it. And it is the beauty of our constitution that there should not be an absolute power. The thinker has, the very framer of our constitutional has very, in the their foresightness has seen this, and this, and nowadays also be very smoothly running our democratic setup because of their foresightness. It is the prime and most important document to ensure protection of rights of individual by promoting a system of rule of law. It is as the experience of different part of the countries all over the world, we saw that it is very difficult to implement rule of law, but our constitutional framework at that very time foreseen what will be the consequences and what will be the challenges in the future on which we need to work. And therefore, in the constitution also, they have given certain space for us to apply their discrimination in this regard. And by way, we are thankful to them. And as we are aware that in this regard, there are certain amendments also. And because of their forcefulness, we can able to do all this in the need of time and the circumstances. It is important for the common man is much acknowledged, but for an advocate who utilizes its provision to help resolve dispute and promote justice, it is exceptionally important. We also aware that Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Dr. V. R. Ambedkar, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, and a galaxy of other stalwart advocates helped draft our constitution most logically. Therefore, the day is also celebrated as Advocate Day. Friends, we also know that that the very preamble of the constitution, which shows the great emphasis the constitution accords to value like liberty, equality, justice, and fraternity to promote utility and integrity to India. To appreciate the great significance of this value, one has to recall the history of India, which from being the greatest economic and military power of the country got enslaved with the consequences of poverty of mass and no assurance of the protection of their right prior to this constitution. And we can at this stage, we have a satisfactory achievement we have achieved after the adoption of this constitution. Rather, the people of India were forced to work even as an indentured labor and were sent to foreign countries like Mauritius, Fiji, West Indies, Africa, where as modern-day slaves. And an unknown number of innocent countrymen were killed. Childs were often, family were uprooted, and an unknown number of women were sold as slaves in foreign market and wealth. Worth slave, several trillion of dollars were looted. Unless we know this, unless we appreciate the region for the due decision, we could reveal the mistake that led to such patric scenario. And therefore, after going through all the past history of the country, we have a very rich and traditional history. Our constitutional maker has very deliberately discussed all those things. And after thorough discussion, our tradition and adopting all the democratic other part of the country setup, they have given up this beautiful constitution. Here, what I mean to say that from the past experience we have, that how such a traditional country got slave and how there were an oppressive attitude. So we have to learn from all those, and the inspiration and the constitution has given us, we have to implement all those. Now, we know, we must know that what we do today could have a great significance, not only for this generation, but also for the future generation. But we must please that we shall do something by our, we should do nothing by our words or by conduct that any way could put at risk the integrity of our country. So we should be very conscious about that, that it is the duty of an individual to have a very conscious in this regard, that the mistakes should not lead our country to the past experience, pathetic condition which we have suffered in the past. Nation first is needed, not just for the society, but also for oneself. For unless the nation is economically and militarily strong, our own future will be at a risk. The history of India teaches us this. The history of India also teaches us that the enemies has always used our own countrymen to oppress us, and later, even those who were misused were not spared. So we have to take precaution, and therefore the constitution has very, if giving the liberty and the fundamental rights, then the duty is also there. We should be also not only talk about the fundamental right we have, but we also have to discuss about the fundamental duty which we have toward our country. That unless the respect, the right of our own, our fellow countrymen, be conscious of justice at the individual and society level toward the concept of unity and integrity. And in this way, we can meet the challenges coming from all way, from the as a threat to our country. So we are on the largest spectrum. If we are analyzing as today, the constitutional, as on the constitution, such an auspicious occasion of the constitutional day, we have to think of that what are the challenges which we have to face in the future. Friends, we need to understand the constitution comprehensively, the region that lead to framing, the process involved, the threat it wants to eliminate, the manner by which threat could be averted, and what and how each one of us could contribute to achieve the constitutional goal. The citizen of India, especially the young generation, have a huge duty toward the society and the nation. We each need to contribute to make India economically prosperous by own words and decision, to reduce the poverty, to protect the right of the poor and downtrodden and ensue, and to enable them to contribute positively, rather waste a large part of their lives in trying merely to survive. And let there be no doubt that when the large human resource that we have is able to and able to contribute positively, our nation would again become the superpower or and that is known as Vishwaguru that it had been earlier, as we know all. Once again, with this word, I like to thank our professor, our vice chancellor, and all organizers to give me this opportunity. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Prashant sir. It is always a pleasure listening to you and having your insight on this day. Now I would like to request Advocate Pradeep Bhattacharya sir to please give some insight on Constitutional Day. Our program won't be complete without your input. Please, sir. Pradeep Bhattacharya sir. Sir, are you there with us? Okay, I think there is some technical issue. We'll proceed with the program. Over to you, Monica ma'am.
Yes. Next, we have a poster display made by our first year students on the theme Constitutional Law. It is a great initiative taken by our first year students itself. And they are displaying their poster. The first one in our row is Anshika Anu from BBA LLB first semester. I would request technical team to please display the poster.
आप सभी को संविधान दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं. बाल मजदूरी हमारे देश की एक गंभीर समस्या है और यह हमारे देश के विकास में बाधा सिद्ध हो सकता है अगर जल्दी इस पर समाधान ना निकाला गया. जिस उम्र में बच्चों को पढ़ना लिखना खेलना चाहिए वह बाल कुछ बच्चे हमें कठिन परिश्रम करते हुए दिखते हैं और बाल मजदूर कोई भी बच्चा अगर बाल मजदूरी कर रहा है तो हमें उसकी शिकायत पुलिस स्टेशन में करनी चाहिए क्योंकि बच्चे ही हमारे देश का भविष्य है और बाल मजदूरी को हमें अगर बाल मजदूरी की जल्दी ही समस्या ना निकाला गया तो यह दीमक की तरह हमारे देश को पूरा खोखला कर देगी. धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू सो मच अंशिका. इट वॉज रियली इन्फॉर्मेटिव. नेक्स्ट वी हैव मनीष कुमार महतो फ्रॉम बीबीए एलएलबी फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर. आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट टेक्निकल टीम टू प्लीज डिस्प्ले द पोस्टर मेड बाय मनीष.
जय भीम. मैं मनीष कुमार बीबीए एलएलबी फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर का छात्र हूं. संविधान दिवस के इस अवसर पर मैं आपके समक्ष खुद के द्वारा बनाए गए एक पोस्टर प्रस्तुत करना चाहता हूं जो कि आधारित है धार्मिक स्वतंत्रता पर. तो जैसा कि हम सब जानते हैं कि भारत एक धर्मनिरपेक्ष राष्ट्र है. यहाँ पर हमें आज़ादी दी गई है कि हम अपने मनपसंद का धर्म चुनें और उसको प्रैक्टिस करें. लेकिन बड़ी दुख की बात है कि यहाँ लोग अपने अधिकारों के प्रति ज़्यादा अवेयर नहीं हैं. उन्हें यह नहीं पता है कि आर्टिकल 25 ये कहता है कि हम किसी भी धर्म को अपना सकते हैं या तो हम किसी के धर्म को अपना नहीं भी सकते. जैसा कि हम देखते हैं आज के मौके पर बहुत सारे धार्मिक दंगे होते हैं जो कि बिल्कुल सही नहीं है और नहीं होना चाहिए. तो ज़रूरत है कि हम अपने अधिकारों को जानें और धर्म के नाम पर ये दंगे फसाद बंद करें. इसी में हमारी भलाई है. धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू सो मच मनीष. इट वॉज रियली इन्फॉर्मेटिव. नेक्स्ट वी हैव अर्पिता श्री फ्रॉम बीबीए एलएलबी फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर. आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट टेक्निकल टीम टू प्लीज डिस्प्ले द पोस्टर मेड बाय अर्पिता.
पहले तो आप सभी को संविधान दिवस की बहुत सारी शुभकामनाएं. आज हम सब यहाँ पे संविधान दिवस के अवसर पर एकत्रित हुए हैं और इस अवसर पर मैं मेरे द्वारा बनाए गए इस पोस्टर को आप सबके सामने प्रस्तुत करना चाहती हूँ जो कि बाल श्रम पर आधारित है. बाल श्रम का मतलब यह होता है कि कार्य करने वाला व्यक्ति जब कानून द्वारा निर्धारित आयु सीमा से छोटा होता है. भारत में 1986 में बाल श्रम अधिनियम पारित हुआ था जिसके अनुसार 14 वर्ष से कम आयु वाले बच्चों को खतरनाक उद्योगों में उनकी नियुक्ति निषेध है. सरकार इस बाल श्रम को केवल जनजागरण और जागरूकता के द्वारा ही खत्म किया जा सकता है. जैसे कि सरकार ने इसे खत्म करने के लिए बहुत सारी योजनाएं भी बनाई थी जैसे स्कूल चलो अभियान आदि ताकि भारत का हर एक बच्चा अपनी मूल शिक्षा प्राप्त कर सके और भारत की उन्नति में अपना योगदान दे सके. धन्यवाद.
That was a good initiative from Arpita Shri. So next, taking the program forward, we have a skit on the theme of journey of making the constitution in the Constituent Assembly. Through this skit, we are trying to portray the wisdom of the makers of the constitution to make it a successful endeavor. Now I would request the tech team to please play the video made by our students.
सारे उपस्थित सदस्यों को सुप्रभात। आज हम सभी यहाँ पर एकत्रित हुए हैं भारतीय संविधान के निर्माण हेतु। हम इस विषय पर प्रकाश डालेंगे कि कैसे संवैधानिक पिता समर्पित रूप से भारतीय संविधान बनाने में शामिल थे।
Part 1. In the coming scene, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar will introduce or suggest the resolution of provision to the scheduled and backward classes, which is a part of today's constitution, provided in Article 15 and 16 of the constitution. So let's take a look on Ambedkar's statement regards to the same.
आने वाले दृश्य में बाबा साहेब अम्बेडकर अनुसूचित और पिछड़े वर्गों के लिए आरक्षण प्रावधान पेश करेंगे या सुझाव देंगे जो संविधान के अनुच्छेद 15 और 16 में प्रदान किए हैं और वो आज के संविधान का एक हिस्सा है। तो आइए उसी के संबंध में अम्बेडकर के बयान पर एक नजर डालें।
आई वुड लाइक टू कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट एंड थैंक्स टू ऑल द मेंबर्स प्रेजेंट हियर। वी आर हियर टू मेक अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया for our India's sustainable future. The foremost thing that we need is freedom. As someone has said, freedom, nothing is more important than the freedom. Let's hope and pray, as a result of the labor of this Constituent Assembly, we shall achieve that freedom and we shall be proud of that. Now, I call B.R. Ambedkar to take the floor.
Mr. Chairman, as we have been witnessing that other minorities have got privilege in the past for a long time. For example, Muslims were receiving privilege since 1892, Christians from the Constitution of 1920, but the scheduled caste has received it from 1935 constitution and practically from 1937, which were also seized by 1939. Therefore, the scheduled caste has received benefits only for 2 years by then, and hence I believe that they should get reservation for a longer time.
I request Bhimrao Ambedkar to form an independent committee for that matter.
I am ready to take the responsibility as directed by the chairman.
Now I call Rajkumari Ambedkar to present her view.
सभापति महोदय, इस कमेटी का सबसे पहला और अहम काम यह होना चाहिए वह कोई ऐसे रास्ते सुझाए जिससे समाज में माइनॉरिटीज को अलग थलग करने की जो रिवाज है उन्हें खत्म कर दी जाए। इनमें माइनॉरिटीज ग्रुप, अंडर प्रिविलेज लोग, तमिल और औरतें भी हैं। मेरे हिसाब से औरतें इस ग्रुप की सबसे बड़ी माइनॉरिटी इकाई है।
सर चेयरमैन, आई वुड लाइक टू ऐड फ्यू पॉइंट्स ऑन दैट मैटर। फॉर हाउ मेनी डेज वी विल प्रोवाइड दिस प्रोटेक्शन, वी विल हैव टू डिसाइड व्हेन इट शैल बी टर्मिनेटेड।
नाउ आई कॉल सरदार पटेल जी टू काइंडली टेक द फ्लोर एंड ऐड सम व्यू ऑन दिस रिगार्ड।
Thank you, Chairman sir, for providing opportunity to add some thought in this matter. खतरा तो यह भी है कि अगर हमने किसी एक विशेष वर्ग को आरक्षण प्रदान किया तो अन्य लोग भी आरक्षण की मांग करेंगे और इस कारण भारत में जातिवाद की लहर फैलती ही जाएगी।
Scene 2. In the next day, sitting of Constituent Assembly, Patel ji and Ambedkar ji are presenting their views on inclusive provision of fundamental rights. So let's move to the house proceeding.
भाग दो अगले दिन संविधान सभा की बैठक में पटेल जी और अंबेडकर जी मौलिक अधिकारों के समाज विरोधी प्रावधानों पर अपने विचार प्रस्तुत कर रहे हैं तो चलिए सदन की कार्यवाही पर चलते
नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट सरदार पटेल जी टू काइंडली प्रेजेंट द क्लॉज फॉर फंडामेंटल राइट्स एज अ चेयरमैन ऑफ एडवाइजरी कमेटी ऑफ फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड माइनॉरिटीज
सर आई बेग टू मूव Two clauses for that regard. Firstly, states shall not discriminate any citizen on ground of sex, caste, religion. And secondly, no citizen shall on any ground of religion, race, caste, sex, place of birth or any of them to access to shops, public restaurants, hotels and public places or the uses of well, tank, bathing huts and public places.
Mr. Chairman, I would like to comment. That the idea of making a gift of fundamental rights to every individual is no doubt very laudable. The question is how to make them effective. The prevalent view is that once the rights are enacted in law, they are safeguarded as experience proves. Rights are protected not only by law but by the society and moral conscience of the society. Social conscience is the only safeguard of all the rights. Fundamental or non-fundamental?
Scene 3, flag. In the next part, let's see the true color, size and India's identity as introduced by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru.
Bhag 3, Dhwaj. अगले भाग में पंडित नेहरू द्वारा पेश किए गए असली रंग, आकार और भारत की पहचान को देखते हैं.
Now I call Pandit Nehru to kindly present their resolution.
Mr. President, it is my proud privilege to move the following resolution. Resolve that the national flag of India shall be horizontal tricolor of deep saffron, white and dark green in equal proportion. In the center of the white band, there shall be a wheel in navy blue to represent the chakra. The design of the wheel shall be that of the wheel which appears as an abacus of the Sarnath, the land capital of Ashoka.
Now I call Sardar Patel to present their resolution.
Sir, I will talk about the provision of citizenship. Every person born or naturally in India according to law shall be citizen of India.
Sir, क्या यूनियन में जिनका भी जन्म हुआ है उन सभी को citizenship और उसके फायदे मिलेंगे?
जरा इन शब्दों पर भी गौर फरमाए महोदय सब्जेक्ट टू ज्यूरिस्डिक्शन अम्बेसडर्स और फॉरेनर्स के बच्चे हमारे नागरिक नहीं कहलाएंगे
मान लीजिए कोई जापानी महिला यहाँ से गुजर रही है और उसको बच्चा हो जाता है तो क्या होगा
सर एज पर हमारे सुप्रीम कोर्ट इट वॉज सेड दैट एनी कैजुअल विजिटर विल नॉट फॉलो दिस क्लॉज
व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन अ मैन Not passing through, but stay for trade or other purposes.
महोदय, मेरा प्रस्ताव यह है कि हमें इस विषय पर अलग से चर्चा करनी चाहिए.
I agree, Chair, that we don't need to manufacture nationality or mind.
I will request all the lawyers and jurists, of them, they are the members of this house, to pay attention on this clause, and a committee of three lawyers should be formed.
Sir, I suggest that in addition to three lawyers, one man of common sense should also be added.
And I do not exclude lawyer from the category of common people.
Scene 5. Introduction of Preamble.
Bhag 5. Samvidhan ki Prastavna.
Now I call Pandit Nehru to take the floor.
Mr. Chairman, I beg to move with the resolution. Which would be our aim and objective of the Constitution. Mr. Chairman, The resolution which I am placing defines our aim, describes our way in which we are going. The resolution that I place before you is in a nature of a pledge, and hope the House will pass this resolution, which is of a special nature. Sir, I beg to move first this Constituent Assembly declare that it is firmly, solemnly resolved to proclaim India as an independent sovereign republic. Second, where shall be guaranteed to secure all people of India justice, social, economical and political, equality of status, opportunity and freedom of thought, expression, belief, vocation, association, action and worship.
Senses. Conclusive remarks by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and Rajendra Prasad.
बहुत अच्छे बी.आर. अम्बेडकर और राजेंद्र प्रसाद की निर्णायक टिप्पणी.
Now I call B.R. Ambedkar to kindly present the conclusive statement and address the House.
Mr. Chairman, looking back on the work of the Constituent Assembly, it is now 2 years, 11 months and 17 days since it first met on 9 December 1946. During this period, the Constituent Assembly has altogether had 11 sessions. These 11 sessions of Constituent Assembly have consumed 165 days. Out of this, the Assembly spent 114 days for consideration of the draft constitution. I would like to thank all the members of the House and my beloved friend for helping in making such a dynamic or living document which will decide India's future steps.
Now, hereby on today, 25th November 1949, the constitution is adopted for India, that is Bharat.
That was a beautiful performance by our students. VC sir, you seem to be enjoying the performance a lot. If you have anything to say to our students, please go ahead.
I was really overjoyed, let me tell you. The way our students have designed this entire skit and they presented it, it's superb. So considering that, they're all from the first year, it's a great thing. Congratulations.
No, I also like to make some comments on it. It is really appreciable and it has changed my thinking towards the university also.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. No, in fact, it would not have happened but for the guidance from our faculty members. While the performance by the students is really commendable, it's all the guidance of our faculty members that would have made the difference.
So everyone is, from my side, I like to congratulate them for this.
Thank you so much, BC sir. Thank you so much, Prashant sir, for enjoying the performance. Next up, Pradeep Kumar Bhattacharya sir is here. Sir, if you are here, kindly share a few words with us. Previously, we had some technical issue, I think. Sir, you have to unmute yourself. You are on mute.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes.
First of all, I would like to tender my apology that in time I couldn't attend the function as because attend the ceremony because I was busy in court, and still from court I have come down, but it is also an important work to be done by me. Without wasting time, the controversy is that whether today Constitution Day or Law Day, it is to be understood because in the year 1979, in the year 1979, the resolution was passed by the Supreme Court Bar Association that National Law Day was to be celebrated. Accordingly, noted jurist and the former parliamentarian L.M. Singh Bisap proposed to in the SCBA, Supreme Court Bar Association, about the National Law Day should be celebrated to mark the adoption of Constitution of 26 number. So from 1979 to 2015, it was being celebrated. And in our bar, especially when I was the Joint Secretary, I introduced this in the year 2003. But suddenly the new turning point came. In the year 2015, 19th November, Modi government decided that it should be the Constitution Day. Now, question is for me whether I am bound by the Supreme Court Bar Association resolution or by the Modi government. Because the Constitution trilogical, this is the big problem. But I would say, sir, Law Day means the importance of the rule of law. The rule of law came by the decision of Dicey. What is rule of law? That's just an example, my friends, that rule of law is like the sun and sun rays. The sun rays we can feel, but the sun we can't go ahead or touch and embrace. Rules are important, but the laws are there. The laws are, when it was born, even the Indian civilization, our culture went born before that law was there. Law is a flow continuum. Justice Iyer Hill, the great jurist, is the flow continuum. Iska na agar na kacha. Kab iska janam hua, kab iski smrityu hogi. Nobody can say. Dr. Radhakrishnan told, it is a running flow of river that it has, though nobody knows what it was born and what where it will end. Law is flow continuum. Rule of law means to maintain the discipline, maintain the social equilibrium in the society for the consolidation of the society. Rules only to maintain the rule of law. That's why Law Day is more important to me than the Constitution. But although Constitution India is the national deed, I would like to say, who drafted Constitution of India? That's very important. Hamari yahan jo jo mool pujya vyakti hote hain, he always remains the answer. So I must say, it was drafted by Sir B.N. Rao, R.A.U. Rao, and advisor to the Constituent Assembly, and thereafter Dr. Ambedkar only piloted that. So we cannot forget Sir B.N. Rao, the greatest composer of the Indian Constitution. But overall, without Constitution, without rule of law, any society cannot run. So for the consolidation, for maintaining the status quo, equilibrium of the society, rule of law is a must, is a must. But this is my insight. Now I am...
Bahut-bahut dhanyavaad, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Next up, we have got some presentations by our senior students on key constitutional personalities who have played prominent role in development of constitution after its commencement. And the first presentation is by our student Uzma Sohail on the background and contribution of Soli Sorabji. Over to you, Uzma.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, you are. But your PPT is not visible.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are here to present the presentation, which is on legal personalities and their contribution. I, Uzma Sohail of BBA LLB, fourth year, would like to start the presentation. The original form and interpretation of Constitution. The original form of Constitution was written in Hindi and English. The Constitution wasn't type or printed. It is handwritten by Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada. The original form of Constitution of India consists only sovereign democratic republic. One of the major changes in the Constitution was when preamble was amendment. The 42nd Amendment changed the original preamble of India from a sovereign democratic republic to a sovereign socialist secular democratic republic, and also change the words unity of the nation to unity and integrity of the nation. Moving towards to the interpretation of the constitution, the enactment of Indian constitution was an ambitious political experiment, whereas Supreme Court, while interpreting the provision enshrined, primarily focused on the plain meaning of the words. It is important for the constitution that it has to be interpreted in a liberal and broad manner, such that any law does not violate the basic structure of the constitution. Now, here are the some reasons for the interpretation. To determine the original meaning of a constitutional provision is interpreted in its original context. Original interpretation and development comprehends the method or strategies available to people attempting to resolve dispute about the meaning or application of the constitution. Now, I would like to move forward to explain the contribution of some eminent jurists. Before explaining his contribution, I will like to give a small introduction about him. Soli Sarabji, Soli Jahangir Sarabji, was born in 1930 in Mumbai. He was designated as a senior advocate in 1971. He served as the Attorney General for India twice, from 1989 to 1990 and from 1998 to 2004. He dedicated his life to service of law. Now, here are the some contribution of Soli Sarabji for the Constitution of India. The respect Sarabji earned for his contribution to the working of Indian Constitution is also because of his off-the-court intervention in terms of erudite column to newspaper. Sarabji was involved in some of the biggest constitutional law cases in Indian history, including landmark case, Keshwanand Bharti case, 1973, before 13 judges of Supreme Court on the basis structure of the constitution, as well as Menaka Gandhi case in 1978, which expanded the scope of Article 21 of the Constitution, the right to life and personal liberty. His contribution was also in the case of S.R. Bommai versus Union of India, which led in shaping the secular nature of India. Soli Sarabji was a man with an unflinching faith in the constitutional ideals, particularly those relating to freedom of speech and human right. He was a defender of civil liberties during the tough emergency era. Thank you. Now I would like to call my other teammates to explain the upcoming slides.
I, Shubhangi of BBLLB fourth year, would like to share the contributions of the eminent jurist P.N. Bhagwati. Justice P.N. Bhagwati was born on December 21, 1921. He enrolled as a lawyer on Feb 24, 1948 and practiced commercial and constitutional affairs before the High Court and the Supreme Court of India from 1948 to 1960. Now, in his field of expertise, he was facilitated by one of the highest civilian award, Padma Vibhushan in public will. He was the one who introduced the concepts of public interest litigation and absolute liability. In addition to being a judge, he held different positions both in India and abroad. That is, he was a member of United Nations Human Rights Committee from 1995 to 2009. By the time Justice Bhagwati became Chief Justice of the Gujarat High Court, he was appointed as chairman of the Legal Aid Committee to give suggestions to the state government on legal aid program. His yearning to support had become almost a fixation. He used to travel to the interiors of rural areas to get to know the real India. His reputation and influence through his work in the field of legal aid was duly appreciated by the public. A tribunal village whose residents benefited from one of the decisions was even renamed as Bhagwati Puran. Now coming to the second most member of the Indian judiciary whose contribution has led to a change system Palisam Nariman. He was born on 10th January 1929 at Yangon, Myanmar. He is India's most respected and well-versed lawyer who was into issues ranging from legal education, practice of law ethics, work-life balance, and several other topics. Palisam Nariman is achiever of two of the most highest ranking felicitations given to any civilian of India, Padma Vibhushan and Padma Bhushan. Now, both of them were Nariman's contribution to jurisprudence and public affairs. Thank you. Now, I would like to call my co-teammate to share her slides of other eminent jurists.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. I'm from BBLLB. H.M. Sarvai was an eminent jurist lawyer and he served as State General of Bombay from 1957 to 1960 and Maharashtra from 1960 until his resignation in 1974. During those years, he was offered various other positions in the Indian judicial system, including a seat on the Indian Supreme Court and as an Attorney General for India. He declined those positions, preferring to contribute through critical analysis of his High Court judgments. He had an effortless command of the English language and its classics. Now, I would like to move on to the next slide. Nani Palkhivala was an Indian jurist and liberal economist. Palkhivala received a great deal of recognition from academics, academic institutions, and the government. In 1963, Palkhivala was offered a seat in Supreme Court, but declined. In 1968, he was offered the position of Attorney General when Law Minister in the Congress government. Palkhivala recounts in his book, We the Nation, after a great deal of hesitation, he agreed. Palkhivala's first book was Law and Practice of Income Tax, co-authored with Jamshed Kanga. This book has served as a veritable Bible for students and practitioners of taxation in India. Now, I would like to call my co-teammate to proceed with the...
Good afternoon to everyone present here. I am Shalvi of BBLLB 7th semester, and I am going to explain the remaining slides about constitutional personalities. First one is M.C. Sitalwad. Motilal Chimanlal Sitalwad was born on 12th November 1884 in Ahmedabad, and he died on 1974. He was lawyer by profession, and he was an eminent Indian jurist who became the first and longest serving Attorney General of India. He also remained the chairman of the First Law Commission of India, which has mandate for legal reform in the country by Government of India. He became the first chairman of Bar Council of India in 1961. He was awarded the Padma Vibhushan, the India's second highest civilian honor, by Government of India in 1957. The next one is Sir Bengal Narsingh Rao. Sir B.N. Rao was born on 26th February 1887 in Mangalore and died on 30th November 1953. He completed his high school from Canara High School, Urwa, in 1901, and he completed his college from Trinity College, University of Madras. He was an Indian civil servant, jurist, diplomat, and statesman known for his key role in drafting of the Constitution of India. He was the constitutional advisor to Constituent Assembly. He was also India's representative to the United Nations Security Council from 1950 to 1952. B.N. Rao was appointed as the constitutional advisor to the Constituent Assembly in formulating the Indian Constitution in 1946. He was responsible for the general structure of its democratic framework of the Constitution and prepared its initial draft in February 1948. This draft was debated, revised, and finally adopted by Constituent Assembly of India on 26 November 1949. By this, our presentation come to an end. Thank you.
Thank you so much, everyone. It was a wonderful and very thoughtful presentation from your end. Next up, we have a poster presentation by the student of our BBA LLB first semester, that is Priya Prasad. I would request the tech team to please display the poster.
पहले तो आप सबको संविधान दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं। आज के दिन पे मैं आपको घरेलू हिंसा के बारे में कुछ बताना चाहती हूँ। ये हमारे देश की बहुत बड़ी परेशानी है। ये बहुत सालों से चलती आ रही है और अभी तक होती है। औरतें चुप क्यों रह जाती हैं? वो ये सोचती है कि अगर हम बाहर जाके बोलेंगे, समाज में बोलेंगे, तो हमें आगे चल के बहुत कठिनाइयां होंगी। पर ऐसा नहीं है। अब हमारा देश आगे बढ़ चुका है कि हम जाके बाहर अपनी बातों को बोल सके। उन चीजों को सहना जरूरी नहीं है। अगर हम इन चीजों को नहीं बोलेंगे तो बच्चे, बड़े, सब पे असर पड़ेगा, हमारे पूरे समाज पे असर पड़ेगा। धन्यवाद।
The next poster is by Ayan Ali Ahmed from BBA LLB first semester.
आप सबको संविधान दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं। मैं अयान अली अहमद आप लोग को ये पोस्टर दर्शाना चाहता हूँ, जिसमें मैंने सबसे पहले अपना संविधान में जो हमारा सबसे पहला लाइन लिखा गया था, वी द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया, जो ये दर्शाता है कि इसमें हम लोग सबको एकता शो करता है कि हम लोग सबको ही बराबर है, इसमें कोई भी भेदभाव नहीं किया गया है। इसके बगल में मैंने तराजू दिखलाया जो इक्वालिटी दिखलाता है कि सब कोई लॉ में बराबर है, हर कोई बराबर है। फिर बगल में मैंने दिखलाया जस्टिस के लिए कि इंसाफ होना जरूरी है। अगर जब इंसाफ नहीं होगा तो एक ऐसा दिन आएगा जब हमारा देश खराब हो सकता है, हमारा देश में मुश्किल आ सकता है। और फिर मैंने बगल में नीचे में किताब बनाया है जो ये शो करता है कि पढ़ाई बहुत जरूरी है, तो इसलिए हमारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के आर्टिकल नंबर 21A में ये दिया गया कि हर बच्चा जो कि 6 से 14 साल का है उसको फ्री और कंपलसरी में एजुकेशन प्रोवाइड करवाया जाएगा। तो ये हम लोग के लिए जरूरी कि हम लोग बच्चों को ज्यादा से ज्यादा पढ़ाएं, क्योंकि जो बच्चे हैं वो हमारे देश के भविष्य है। और बगल में मैंने इंडिया का नक्शा बनाया है जो कि ये शो करता है, जिससे मैं ये शो करना चाहता हूँ कि अगर हम लोग चाहते कि हमारा देश और भी ज़्यादा सफल हो, तो ये हम लोग को चाहिए कि हम लोग इसके लिए मिलकर काम करें, क्योंकि ये एक आदमी से पॉसिबल नहीं है, एक आदमी देश को करने के लिए उतना पॉसिबल नहीं है। इसलिए हम लोग सबको ही मिलकर काम करें और अपने देश को और सफल बनाएं। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद।
सो दिस वॉज अ पोस्टर प्रेजेंटेशन बाई आर स्टूडेंट्स। Next up, we have Nukkad Natak prepared by our students on the theme of fundamental rights. This is basically for the awareness of the people. So I would request the tech team to please play the video.
Dekho, dekho, natak, dekho, natak mein hai kaisi baat, kaisi baat, kaisi baat. Samvidhan ke aise vidhan, phir ye toli aayi hai, sandesh.
समानता और भेदभाव जैसे शब्दों का उपयोग अपने जीवन में बहुत करते हैं, परंतु क्या वास्तविक जीवन में हम इसे समझते हैं? आइए देखते हैं इसे।
मालकिन मुझे प्यास लगी है, क्या मुझे एक गिलास पानी मिल सकता है? रोज तो मैं अपनी बोतल लेके आती थी लेकिन आज लाना भूल गई।
बिट्टू इनके लिए पानी लेके आओ। रुको, इसमें नहीं, डिस्पोजल वाले गिलास में लेके आओ।
देखा आप सब लोगों ने, हमारे समाज में समानता का अधिकार, संविधान के अनुसार हम सब एक समान है, इसीलिए समानता हमारा अधिकार है, अधिकार है, अधिकार है।
हमारे पूजनीय बाल गंगाधर तिलक जी ने हम सबसे कहा था कि स्वतंत्रता हमारा जन्मसिद्ध अधिकार है, परंतु क्या वास्तविक जीवन में हम इसे समझते हैं? आइए देखते हैं फिर भी इनके कैसे व्यवहार है।
माजी माजी मुझे नौकरी लगी है, क्या मैं नौकरी करने जा सकती हूँ?
क्या नौकरी, तुम्हें क्या जरूरत है नौकरी की? मेरा बेटा तो कमा ही रहा है।
देखा आप लोगों ने, क्या यही है हमारे समाज में स्वतंत्रता की परिभाषा? जो लोग दूसरे को आजादी नहीं देते उन्हें खुद भी इसका कोई हक नहीं होता, क्योंकि स्वतंत्रता हमारा अधिकार है, अधिकार है, अधिकार है।
हमारे संविधान के अनुसार सबको अपना जीवन जीने का संपूर्ण अधिकार है, परंतु वास्तविक जीवन में आइए देखते हैं क्या यह अधिकार सबके पास है।
रुकिए रुकिए, आप कहाँ जा रहे हैं?
क्यों, मुझे अंदर जाने की अनुमति नहीं है।
नहीं, आपकी वेशभूषा से देख के लग रहा है कि आप हिंदू हैं, आपको मंदिर जाना चाहिए, मस्जिद नहीं।
हमारे संविधान के 25 से 26 अनुच्छेद के अनुसार धार्मिक स्वतंत्रता हमारा अधिकार है और ये अधिकार हमसे कोई नहीं छीन सकता, क्योंकि ये हमारा अधिकार है, अधिकार है, अधिकार है।
आजकल हमारे देश में कम उम्र के बच्चों का काफी शोषण किया जा रहा है, उन्हें प्रताड़ित किया जा रहा है। आइए हम आपको दिखाते हैं उनके कुछ झलक।
ये कैसे काम कर रही हो तुम? जल्दी जल्दी हाथ चलाओ, देखो उधर कितना गंदा है, सब साफ करो।
मैडम मैं सुबह से काम कर रही हूँ, क्या मैं थोड़ी देर आराम कर लूँ?
कोई आराम आराम नहीं मिलेगा, पूरा काम करो, जल्दी खत्म करो।
संविधान के अनुसार हम किसी भी 14 वर्ष से कम आयु वाले बच्चे से जबरदस्ती काम नहीं करा सकते, क्योंकि ये एक दंडनीय अपराध है।
हम संस्कार और संस्कृति जैसे शब्दों का प्रयोग तो अपने जीवन में बहुत करते हैं, इनके बारे में काफी सुना भी है हमने, लेकिन आइए आज हम आपको दिखाते हैं कि कैसे हमारे संविधान हमें ये मौलिक अधिकार देते हैं।
पता है मैं एक नागपुरी शिक्षा संस्थान खोलना चाहता हूँ।
नागपुरी क्यों, हिंदी क्यों नहीं? हिंदी हमारी राष्ट्रभाषा है, सब इसके विरोध कर रहे हैं, तुम बोल नहीं पाओ।
विरोध क्यों कर रहे हैं? हमारे संविधान में सबको अधिकार दिया हुआ है कि हम अपने रीति रिवाज संस्कृति को बचाए रखने के लिए किसी भी संस्था का निर्माण कर सकते हैं, ये हमारा अधिकार है, अधिकार है, अधिकार है।
तो आइए देखते हैं हमारे संविधान के आखिरी मौलिक अधिकारों को।
माँ मेरे पति ने मुझे मारा, मैं इसकी शिकायत कोर्ट जाके दर्ज कराऊंगी।
नहीं, क्या कर रही हो तुम? पूरे समाज में हमारा नाम खराब करवाना चाहती हो?
नहीं माँ, हमारे संविधान के आखिरी मौलिक अधिकार के अनुसार अगर हम पे किसी तरह का जुर्म होता है तो हम उसकी शिकायत कोर्ट जाकर दर्ज करा सकते हैं बिना किसी के।
संविधान के आखिरी मौलिक अधिकारों को सभी अधिकारों का सार माना जाता है। इसके अनुसार सर्वोच्च न्यायालय को इन सबका संरक्षण माना जाता है और वहां जाकर हम किसी भी वक्त अपना शिकायत दर्ज करा सकते हैं, ये हमारा अधिकार है, अधिकार है, अधिकार है।
संविधान हमारी शान है,
इसमें हमारी जान है,
कई भाषाएं और सैकड़ों विधि हमारा संविधान है,
सबको जोड़ के रखे वो संविधान है।
It was a brilliant performance by our students. They have put in really great amount of effort in making this Nataka a successful one. So now I would request our Vice Chancellor sir to please declare the winner for the poster making competition. I think there is some technical glitch. Just, yeah. Sir, give it a minute for our tech team to share the...
So, congratulations, Arpita Shree, BBLLB. So, for getting the first position with regard to the poster making competition. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Arpita Shree. So,
thank you, ma'am.
So now I would request our assistant registrar, sir, Professor Arvind Kumar, sir, to please give the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Professor Akriti. Respected Vice Chancellor, sir, and our Honorable Shri Prashant Kumar Singh Ji, Member Bar Council of India, my dear faculties, and dear students. Today, we are very much thankful to Shri Prashant Kumar Singh Ji for his valuable time, informative speech, and very, very valuable appreciation called it to our students who have performed very, very well in today's program. We are deeply indebted to him, and we are sure that we will continue to get his support and time in days to come. We are also thankful to our VC sir for his gracious presence and guidance, without which the events would not have been so enthralling and informative. We are also very thankful to the students who have produced a brilliant program, a very, very informative skit, and a very, very informative depiction of the journey of Constitution, how it was made and how it was passed. Many of us were not aware of the intricacies involved and things like that. So even the information about noted jurists and noted advocates was very, very informative to all of us. We are thankful to the organizers and the technical team for their brilliant presentation. And we hope that we'll continue with the tradition of organizing it so very well, thankfully. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Next up, I would request everyone to please switch on the camera for the group photography.
Thank you, Akriti Madam.
Sir, before we end this program, I would like to thank our registrar, sir, Professor Arvind Kumar, sir, Alok, sir, for guiding us through and through, all the students who has taken active participation in here, our tech team, and also our vice chancellor, sir, and Prashant Kumar, sir, to always take out some time and be present here with us. Over to you, Monica, ma'am, for the final touch.
सैकड़ों विधि हजारों विधान हैं जो जोड़कर सबको साथ रखे वो संविधान है विद दैट हैव अ वेरी गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कमिंग हियर एंड जॉइनिंग अस
थैंक यू सो मच एवरीवन